Hi, this is David from MinuteEarth. But in Tolkien's fantasy world, the hobbits are known for two seemingly contradictory things, being small and being hungry. The average hobbit is less than half the size of a human, yet eats 7 times a day. And while that may seem like just another delightful literary detail about our favorite hairy-footed halflings, it's actually just about how much food the laws of nature predict a hobbit would need to survive. Since the basic internal workings of all warm-blooded animals are really similar, there's no reason to believe that the cells inside Bilbo Baggins would have drastically different energetic needs than those inside a pygmy shrew or a whale. So we can take the rule we use to predict how much food warm-blooded creatures need to eat and use it for Bilbo, too. This rule, Kleiber's Law, states that an animal's energy requirement scales in proportion to the 3/4 power of its mass. An elephant that's 100,000 times more massive than a mouse doesn't have to eat 100,000 times as much as the mouse. It only has to eat about 6,000 times more. So a small animal has to eat a larger amount, relative to its body size, than a large animal does. Why energy needs scale at this particular proportional power is still not completely clear. The square cube law gets us partway there. It tells us that because volume is proportional to the cube of the length, but area is only proportional to the square of the length, as something gets bigger, its volume increases faster than its surface area. Big animals have way less surface area relative to their volume than small animals do. And since heat loss is proportional to surface area, they lose heat less quickly and therefore need less energy per kilogram to stay warm enough to survive. If that were the only thing going on, we would predict that energy consumption would scale to the power of 2/3. But for most animals, it seems to scale to the power of 3/4. That's probably thanks to a few other smaller differences that affect the scaling between large and small critters, like their proportion of super energy-hungry tissues or the efficiency of their circulatory systems. But even if we don't know exactly why Kleiber's Law works, we can use it to predict how much a hobbit would need to eat. Based on some absurdly time-consuming deliberations and calculations, we estimated Bilbo Baggins' weight at about 16 kilograms. According to the law, Bilbo would need to eat around 500 calories a day, while an average 82-kilogram man would need to eat 1,800 calories a day to survive. But the amount of food the human eats represents just 0.5% of his total mass, whereas the amount of food Bilbo would need to eat would represent 0.8% of his total mass. So while most of us humans can meet our daily needs with 3 meals and a snack, a hobbit would need a few extra opportunities to chow down. 4 full hobbit-sized meals and 3 snacks would be just about enough to keep his stomach from rumbling. So, anyone in the mood for second breakfast?